going to give you an overview of what we've achieved on the XF and how, from an engineering point of view, we've achieved our goal. This is a completely new car. More dynamic reward, more refinement, comfort and space, more technology and more efficiency. So the original XF was launched in 2007 and it was the first Jaguar sedan that was produced solely under Ian Callum's design leadership. And it introduced a new, bolder Jaguar brand to the world, bringing new customers who appreciated its fresh approach to design. Its popularity endures. In the last full year of its life, it sold almost 50,000 units, and that was more than any other year. By the end of 2014, we had sold more than 280,000 XF to customers in more than 100 countries. Thanks to you and the rest of our friends in the media, the XF is also our most awarded Jaguar ever, collecting 145 global awards over its lifetime. So for us, that was quite an act to follow. But with the arrival of the new XE, our compact sport sedan, this gave us the opportunity to create a more mature and more sophisticated XF. An XF is no longer the entry point into the brand. Instead, it's very much the centre of gravity. So the new XF is a completely brand new car, save for a few bolts on the original. Fundamental to our vision of this car is the new architecture. At the heart of the new XF is our advanced aluminium intensive architecture. XF is the second car to be launched with this foundation within JLR. XE was the first, which is soon to go on sale in the US, and the F-PACE is going to follow shortly after. From day one, we designed the architecture to deliver a whole range of vehicles, body styles and wheelbases, for different segments, different attributes, and most of all, different customers. So what is an architecture? Well, the architecture represents a flexible, modular approach to engineering cars. It's a set of shared design and, crucially, manufacturing principles and philosophies, like a toolbox, if you will. And why do we do this? Well, the benefit to the customers is really simple. A shared architecture as our foundation means that we can migrate new technologies, features and powertrains and electrical systems faster across our range of Jaguars. The bottom line, and most evident in 2015, is we can produce more great Jaguars much faster. What it is not is sharing large amounts of parts, because it's just simply not possible to deliver our breadth in the range. So for the XF, it shares only 20% of the parts with the XE. There is another significant milestone reached with our new XF. With its introduction, now every Jaguar features a light, stiff, aluminium-intensive body structure. Following an investment of about $650 million, it also means that our Castle Bromwich plant, which is the home of the XJ, the F-Type and the XF, now only makes aluminium-intensive vehicles. So you see, Jaguar's industry-leading aluminium expertise built over 15 years is fundamental to everything that we do, engineering our cars to be efficient, dynamic, refined and, of course, striking design. The all-new XF features 75% aluminium, and aluminium provides optimum results in a wide range of areas. Stiffness, crash, performance, handling, refinement, and of course, sustainability and efficiency. We use aluminium stampings on the skin panels, extrusions in the sill, and variable thickness castings around the car. But we don't just use aluminium, we also use magnesium in the cross-car beam and front-end carrier. But we also use high-strength steels, such as boron reinforcements in the A-post and the B-post. So the aluminium-intensive body structure is inherently light and very stiff. In fact, our body and weight weighs just 621 pounds, which is about the same as a Fiat 500L. And whilst being 11% lighter than the current XF, the new XF is also 28% stiffer. For XF, we've used our world-leading aluminium expertise to meet the design team's vision for the car's proportion and stance. Consider the body side. The entire body side of the car is one complete stamping, and this highly complex panel weighs less than 13 pounds. We've also applied our learning from F-Type in drawing the tight, crisp radii for feature lines underpinning the design. Today's XF is actually recognised and won many awards for its dynamic capability and its appeal, its agility, responsiveness and precision. It is the driver's choice. We have used our engineering knowledge and proven expertise to produce cars as refined as the XJ and as sporty as the F-Type to deliver a new XF that will become a benchmark for its combination of driver reward and occupant comfort. It delivers a sports car driving experience with sedan practicality and comfort. It does that by employing sports car chassis technology. XF uses aluminium double wishbone suspension up front with integral link rear. And why do we do this? Well, at Jaguar, we just believe this is the best suspension layout. It provides the optimum balance of sharp, precise handling and comfortable control of the premium ride. Double wishbone is a no-compromise sports car design and offers opportunity to fine-tune the handling and comfort balance. We've taken this setup from the F-Type. The knuckles are made from hollow cast aluminium for the best possible weight and stiffness. And why is stiffness so important in sedan mix? Well, precise and immediate. It's the Jaguar DNA. At the rear, we use integral link rear suspension, which allows us to create a mature ride and quality of supple impact absorption without losing any of the dynamic precision and responsiveness that the XF is loved for. Integral link is the most sophisticated and tunable chassis arrangement. Jaguar is the only manufacturer in this segment to use this technology. It outperforms conventional multi-link arrangement both dynamically and in refinement and ride. It does this by providing high lateral and camber stiffness for handling poise and control, precise toe control for steering precision, but longitudinal compliance for ride comfort. To ensure that XF continues to be a standard bearer for Jaguar DNA, it will feature two levels of chassis specification. Firstly, a new frequency-dependent passive damping system, which uses an additional bypass valve to further broaden the tuning window, providing enhanced comfort and excellent body control. Secondly, Jaguar Adaptive Dynamics, which is a continuously variable damping system, which monitors the environment up to 500 times per second, and it makes minute adjustments to preserve dynamics, character, and ride comfort. In XF, we offer configurable dynamics too, which is another feature developed from the F-Type. All the cars we'll be driving during this program feature the adaptive dynamics. A new XF will offer optional all-wheel drive. This is an all-new system versus the current F-Type and the current XF. It uses a chain drive with a transfer case instead of gears. It's 16% lighter and 10% more efficient versus our outgoing transfer case. And this is crucial, it's even quieter. Like F-Type, all-wheel drive XF will feature intelligent driveline dynamics, or IDD, which preserves the rear-wheel drive bias on the car, predicting levels of traction available at the rear, and sends the torque only to the front when it's required. The result is optimum torque distribution in all conditions, improving traction and ability. All-wheel drive XF models also benefit from an optional, all-new feature called adaptive surface response. In all-wheel drive models equipped with adaptive dynamics, ADSR replaces the winter mode and the Jaguar drive control. It determines what kind of surface the car is driving on and selects the most appropriate mode for the throttle, the traction control, the steering and the transmission. It's an excellent example of Land Rover's all-terrain expertise and Jaguar dynamics skill combined. Even without all-wheel drive, XF can make smooth progress in difficult conditions. All automatic XFs will also feature all-surface progress control. Essentially, it works like a low-speed launch control, and enables the car to pull away smoothly on slippery surfaces. The driver just steers and the system does the rest. Why is this important? Well, ordinary traction control only intervenes once the traction is lost, and on surfaces such as ice, this is just too late. ASPC ensures that precisely and only the required amount of torque reaches the wheels, ensuring smooth progress without any drama. Another technology from the F-Type is torque vectoring by braking. By subtle braking of the unloaded inside wheels during cornering, TVBB optimizes and minutely corrects the car's trajectory through the corner. Bottom line, it's inherently fast, safe, and provides precise progress through and out of the corners. On all-wheel drive XF, TVBB is also integrated with IDD control, providing maximum traction throughout the corner. And as you'd expect, the new XF features electric power-assisted steering, a technology we've proven on the F-Type. For XF, we are confident that it delivers the benchmark steering feel, response, and precision in the segment, as well as far greater opportunity for fine-tuning compared to hydraulic systems. It also reduces fuel consumption and CO2 emissions by up to 3%. E-PASS also allows us to introduce advanced driver assistance systems. XF will have the performance to match its dynamics thanks to its sports car powertrain. In the US, we will offer the 3-litre V6, delivering 340 or 380 horsepower, with 332 pound-feet of torque. You remember this engine from the F-Type. Both versions feature a twin vortex supercharger for optimum drivability and performance. The 380 horsepower version is exclusive to the XFS and is matched to an 8-speed automatic. It's available both rear and all-wheel drive and delivers 0 to 60 in just 5 seconds. But new XF's lightweight also generates a 9% improvement in fuel economy. That allows us to offer 30 miles per gallon on the rear-wheel drive V6. From mid-2016, we will also introduce an i4 diesel. Shared with the XE and F-PACE, the Jaguar Ingenium diesel offers advanced, lightweight aluminium construction. It's designed and built entirely in-house by Jaguar Land Rover, and at our $750 million engine manufacturing centre in the UK. Introduced in North America, the XE and XF, this 2-litre turbo produces 180 horsepower and 317 pound-feet of torque. Both of these engines match the advanced 8-speed ZF Auto. This intelligent auto can adapt its shift schedule in real time according to how the car is being driven. Sporting shifts those spiriting drivers and softer, more relaxed shifts during gentler driving. The transmission offers a sport mode with the option of steering wheel mounted paddle shift control. And by selecting eco drive mode and the Jaguar drive control, the transmission automatically adopts the most economical shift pattern, thus for optimizing fuel economy. To ensure the best refinement possible, the torque converter features a pendulum damper. This serves to smooth vibration at low engine speeds, allowing the transmission to upshift during light driving loads. Lighter, fuel-efficient powertrains, lightweight aluminium body, and a sports car chassis system make for a real driver's car, but also a fundamentally efficient one. We've used cutting-edge computational fluid dynamics to optimise airflow over and under the car, aiding refinement and fuel efficiency. This contributes towards a coefficient of drag of just 0.28.